How's it going, guys? Welcome back to BlackTideTV. On today's video, I've got my 2000 sub special Q&A. I got a ton of questions through YouTube and Twitter, but that is not the end of it. I will have future Q&A videos. So if your question that you wanted answered isn't answered today, or maybe you come up with a further question for me, tweet at me with the hashtag AskBTide. I will be keeping track of that hashtag, and I will be answering any questions found on there in the next video. So even though I'm not asking for questions in particular from this point forward, if you do have any questions, tweet with the hashtag AskBTide. I will find them for the next video. So we're finally getting to our 2K Q&A today. I've also got some announcements to bring up before that, but I was just doing the math last night, and I think you might find this interesting, but I was doing the math last night trying to figure out what our kind of growth rate is right now, just a linear growth rate. And if we continue on this linear growth rate, as in non-exponential, exponential being the more you grow, the quicker you grow, which is actually how it happens on YouTube. But continuing linearly, if we just continue with the same growth pattern that we've had over the last, say, week, we will hit 3K before the end of the year. So hashtag 3K 2016 is pretty nuts. I never thought that would happen. I honestly didn't even think we'd get 2K, because at the rate that we were growing when I was hoping to hit 2K, it was basically impossible. We were growing at like 2 subs a day or something like that, and we needed to grow at like 6 or 7 subs a day just to break 2K by the end of the year. And then all of a sudden we had this massive explosion of subscribers, and we've been getting like 35 subs a day for the last week or so. So if we continue on this at this rate, we will hit 3K, about 3.5K before the end of the year, which is absolutely nuts. I never could have imagined it, but pretty ridiculous. And that's only linear, and we're growing exponentially. So if with any kind of luck, we will actually grow faster than that, and we might actually hit 4K by the end of the year if we're growing fast enough at that point. So that's pretty nuts, just absolutely ridiculous. I never thought that would happen. So a big thanks to all of the subscribers that have been here for quite some time. A lot of the subscribers that have just joined, all of these guys that are brand new, my 400 new subscribers that I gained in the last 28 days. So welcome to the channel. Thank you for subscribing and always hitting that like button and sharing the videos and all that good stuff. Jumping right into these announcements, I've got the NinjaRay21 becoming a moderator alongside Lone Cap. Lone Cap has been a moderator for quite some time, but the NinjaRay has just been promoted to moderator a couple days ago. I didn't tweet about it, I didn't make a public statement, because I did want to save it for this video. So congrats to NinjaRay for becoming a moderator. He's been on the channel for a while, he's been really active, and he's been leaving likes and commenting certain conversations. And when someone is that active, I tend to reach out to them, because I want to grow this family at BlackTideTV, give some more people the keys to the castle, let them kind of help out the community by answering comments and just carrying my words. So he is going to be doing that. If you see the NinjaRay, or if you see Lone Cap ever commenting on your stuff, if I'm not there, if I'm not really answering comments or something like that, I will answer as many as I can, but recently the comments have been crazy and I need all the help I can get. So NinjaRay and Lone Cap do carry my word, and they will be answering some comments and stuff in the comments section. They are also totally in charge of bans and all that good stuff in streams whenever they happen, so be on the lookout for them. Don't piss them off, because they will ban you. But big congrats to NinjaRay21 for becoming a mod. The second announcement today is concerning Epic Variant Reviews for Infinite Warfare. That is the most popular series on my channel right now. I know you guys are all hot and horny to get some more Epic Variant Reviews, and I am working away on those. I did run out of Epic Variants myself. I had to go over to Renman's account to grab a couple gameplays and to do some testing. So I did get 3 gameplays last night. We'll have a new Epic Variant Review as early as tomorrow. Now, I did put out a poll on my Twitter a while ago asking you guys which Epic Variant you would like to see next, and the results were an overwhelming Volk Corruption. Now, see, the problem with the Volk Corruption is we don't exactly know how it works. We know that you get a Mo Money medal, and that is how you get your extra experience gain with each kill, but we don't know the specifics of the Mo Money medal. We've seen a lot of different answers for that on Reddit from random people that claim they've done testing, but there's no exact way to really test in-game with there not being any barracks, not being able to see how much XP you got in a single match without including match bonus and all that stuff. We don't have a official word from Activision or Infinity Ward or Joe Seacoat. I have messaged Joe Seacoat like 2 or 3 times now, and he still has not got back to me. So basically, we're kind of up in the air right now. I have no idea what the experience gain is for the Mo Money medal, for the vote corruption, so I can't cover it. I'm not going to give you guys any false information with, oh, I think it does this, or I'm pretty sure it does that, and there's no exact way to test in-game right now, so I'm going to be doing whatever came in second in that poll will be the first video for the Epic variant reviews going forward, which will be either tomorrow or the next day, something like that. I want to get another one out very, very soon, because I know you guys are, like I said, all hot and horny for them. It's like the best series on my channel right now. It is one of the most popular series that I've ever done. So yeah, I'm going to try and work and get one out either tomorrow or the next day, but it just won't be the vote corruption. I do still have the vote, like Renman still has the vote corruption. I can still grab a gameplay whenever, but it's just going to be a while until we get some information on it before I can post a video of it. And last but not least, guys, I'm finally getting a new phone. I've been running the iPhone 4 for 5 to 6 years now. It's getting pretty old. It crashes a lot of my apps. It's super slow. I can't really answer any comments on YouTube. I can barely tweet back to people on Twitter. It's just, it's pretty old. It's my baby, but it's pretty old. And I'm finally getting a new one. So I'm going to get the iPhone 6S in 2 to 3 days. So in 2 to 3 days, if I'm totally AFK for a day or two, I will still post videos. I'll still get videos out there, but I might be a little bit AFK in the comments section, or the videos will be super small and super simple and super short, just because I'll want to get the videos out there for daily uploads and then go straight back to getting my phone all set up. But that is why I'll be just setting up my phone for the next couple of days. Whenever it gets here, it should be here either tomorrow or the next day, but I'll be setting up my phone then. But what does this mean going forward? Well, it means faster response time. Like I said, with my old phone, I could not, like, straight up, I cannot answer comments from my old phones. For like YouTube comments, can't do it. Twitter, replying to tweets and all that stuff, barely can do it. But now with a new phone, I should be able to reply to your YouTube comments wherever I am, whenever I am. I should be able to just get on there and talk to you guys all the time. So faster response time, I'll be able to tweet more. I'll be able to keep you guys updated a lot more often. So that's super exciting. I'll be getting that new iPhone 6S in a couple days, and I'm really excited for that. Now that is all of the announcements that I have for you today. Let's jump into these questions. Now that I've got my mystical list of Q&A questions in hand, I'd like to let you guys know that all of the answers you're about to hear are completely raw, uncut. I didn't go through and really read into any of these questions when I got them. I kind of just glanced at them, said, okay, yeah, that's for the Q&A, took a picture of it, and then went on my merry way. So I didn't actually sit there and look at each of these questions and really think out an answer, because I wanted this to be as honest as possible. That's the whole point for a Q&A, in my opinion, is just to have that more personal connection. And I want you guys to know the first thing that comes to my mind when I think of these questions. So this is all going to be me on the spot. If you hear any jump cuts, it's just because I either had to pause to take a breath, or if I got an interruption or something like that. It's not because I've paused to think about what I want to say, because I don't want to say anything wrong or anything like that. I want this to be as honest as possible. So moving forward, these are in no particular order. Let's start with the NinjaRay21. I just thought of a good question. Who is your favorite COD YouTuber, or top five if you do not have a specific favorite? So I don't have a favorite COD YouTuber. I do like the zombies YouTubers a lot for some reason. I'm not a big zombies player, but I like the energy of the zombies YouTubers. Like Mr. Raffle Waffles is probably my favorite zombies YouTuber, just because he's got this energy and he's just such an interesting character, and I love to watch his stuff. As far as actual COD YouTubers, because a lot of people wouldn't consider zombies and COD YouTubers to be the same thing, I used to watch Drifter a lot. Drifter was actually one of my big inspirations when I got into it, just because he's so straight to the point. He didn't get into this extra banter or anything like that. It was just like, right away, like, this is the weapon, this is what it does, this is what you use it for, do this, and it's like, yes sir, right away, boss. It's just like very straight to the point, and I really like that about his content, because it's very informational. I like those informational kind of things, those educational kind of videos. Like, I watch Charlie Intel all the time to just get the news. But apart from that, I don't really watch a whole lot of COD YouTube. I think that a lot of COD YouTube is going downhill a little bit, apart from the smaller channels. Mangoes and Whales, definitely check him out. I've got a link to him on my channel. He's a very, very small channel. I think he's got like 200 subs now or something, but he does great videos. For the most part, Call of Duty, like the big Call of Duty YouTubers that I could say here and you would go, oh yeah, I know who that is. For the most part, I don't like them that much. I don't like how their content has kind of gone downhill. They're getting really clickbaity. I'm just not a fan of a lot of big Call of Duty YouTubers, quote unquote, big Call of Duty YouTubers anymore. That's not my style anymore. For the most part, when I'm watching YouTube, I'm not even watching gaming stuff, like, or Call of Duty stuff. I will watch the odd gaming video, but for the most part, I'm watching like comedies or skits, or I'm watching other like educational videos. I'm not really into the big kind of Call of Duty only YouTube. I'm not like YouTube is so much more than just Call of Duty, and that's what I use it for. So Ninja Ray again, we've got a couple questions this time. He's got favorite COD, what got you into YouTube, and who inspired you? So my favorite Call of Duty would be Modern Warfare 2. It was the first Call of Duty I ever played, and it was just, it's great. I cannot wait for the remaster. It's going to be insane. Whenever they do it, or if they do it, I'm pretty sure they're going to have a remaster of Modern Warfare 2. But it'll just be ridiculous. I'll be crushing so much in that game. Just be aware that if they come out with a Modern Warfare 2 remaster in the next couple of years and they bring it alongside another Call of Duty game, you can just kiss that other Call of Duty game goodbye, because I will never, ever, ever play it. I will just be playing Modern Warfare 2 Remastered from the time it comes out to the day I die, because I'm so excited for it. Like, Modern Warfare 2 is just absolutely my favorite Call of Duty game ever. You cannot beat Modern Warfare 2, in my opinion. Just being the first Call of Duty game, I feel like it had that weight on my soul, just being like the first one that I played being the best, and I feel like a lot of people are that way. Say you played Black Ops 2 for your first Call of Duty game, you might think that that is the best, and say you even played like something like Advanced Warfare for your first Call of Duty game, you might think that that is the best. And I just feel like that is something that gets into all of us, is that if you play the game, if it was the very first Call of Duty you played, there's a good chance that it's going to be your favorite, and Modern Warfare 2 is no exception. First Call of Duty game I ever played, and definitely my favorite. What got me into YouTube? Just seeing that this is out there. At the beginning, I actually tried a couple other YouTube channels before this that you'll never ever find. But I tried other YouTube channels and stuff, and I didn't really know what I was doing. I was still quite young, obviously. I had no idea. I didn't have any good editing or anything like that. I was kind of like, I was doing the old style where I was like holding a camera in front of a TV recording gameplay and stuff, which was just ridiculous. But just knowing that it was out there, seeing other people that could actually make a living off of playing video games and talking about them. I'm a big person for debating. I like talking things out. I like discussing things at length. And to be able to do that on top of another thing that I love, playing video games, and to inform and educate people and entertain people all at the same time, and to be able to put that out on the internet and make a living off that is really crazy to me. And it's something that I really want to be able to do. So that is what got me into YouTube, is just knowing that this is out there, knowing that I can do this, that it is a possibility, and just knowing that if I give it my all, I can possibly make it to that point someday. And who inspired you? Well, I kind of mentioned Drifter in the last one, where he was one of the first big Call of Duty YouTubers I first started watching, and how he was very formal and how he was very educational and also entertaining all at the same time. He was one of the first Call of Duty YouTubers I ever saw, one of the first gaming YouTubers I ever saw. And then, of course, I kind of branched out. I saw some other gaming YouTubers. I couldn't really tell you who they are now. There's a lot of gaming YouTubers that were really big in the day when I first started getting into it, and now they're like nowhere to be seen. But There have been others that have inspired me, but for the most part, it's just been the inspiration of YouTube itself. Just being able to see that YouTube is out there and being able to do that as a living and be able to put this content out there and entertain you guys, to be able to see that it's out there is my main inspiration, not any particular channel. Kevin3508, when did you start getting interested in COD, and what was your first COD? So Modern Warfare 2 is my first COD. When I first started getting interested in it, I was never really a big first-person shooter kind of person. I was more like a platformer. I liked all of, like, the super simple games, or like the hack and slash God of War. And then I went over to my friend's house, and he wanted me to 1v1 him in Call of Duty. I'm like, what the fuck is Call of Duty? I'm like, I don't know what this is. And he put me in this game, and I had a really hard time controlling it and all this stuff. It was just very, very difficult. We were playing Modern Warfare 2. Actually, no, we were playing COD 4. We were playing COD 4, and he just wrecked me. He was like quick scoping me and everything. I'm trying to kill him with like the M16 here, and I can't do dick all. And it was just like a terrible, terrible experience. And I went home that day, and I'm like, that's never going to happen again. So I went out and I bought Modern Warfare 2. And Modern Warfare 2 is when I first started playing on my own. And I got really, really, really good at Modern Warfare 2. And then the next time I went over to his house, he also had Modern Warfare 2. And I'm like, all right, boy, bring it. And I just completely destroyed him. Just hands down, just wrecked him at Modern Warfare 2. And it's one of my fondest memories of Call of Duty, is that he thought he was just the greatest. And that really inspired me to go out and try and to get better at this one game. And then I just completely fell in love with the series from Modern Warfare 2, and the rest is, as they say, history. I'm flicking through. I took a bunch of random pictures in between my pictures of questions from Twitter, my questions from YouTube. All right, we're back on the questions here. Lone Cap, what about the live streams? Are you not able to do them as often anymore? I can do live streams just as often. I'm just not posting as many right now. Live streams were becoming a big part of the channel. Recently, I was doing Fallout live streams and other things like that. And I do want to get back into that, the B-Tide plays and other live streams for Call of Duty and other live streams for other things as well. And I will be getting to those eventually. Just right now, it's because of this Call of Duty rush with all of the new subs coming in to watch all the new Call of Duty stuff. I'm trying to get as much Call of Duty content out as I can. And rather than live streaming other games at night when I used to live stream at like 12, 1 o'clock. Instead of that, doing that, I'm like grinding, trying to get clips and stuff. I'm so far behind on clips for both Modern Warfare Remastered and Infinite Warfare. I'm just trying to grind my ass off, trying to get camos, trying to get gold so I can do golden weapon reviews, trying to unlock salvage and keys so I can do openings and I can get other kind of things like epic variants, that's what I'm trying to say, so I can do more epic variant reviews. I'm just trying to do all of this other stuff for Call of Duty right now, and I will be getting back into the live streams eventually. I do want to establish this channel as not just a Call of Duty channel, but as a gaming channel or pop culture channel in general, and hopefully I can work on that going forward. But I will be doing more live streams very soon. Just right now, it's just this big Call of Duty rush. Once I get caught up on content for Call of Duty, then I will be getting back into more live streams. At Megaloid asked, do you plan to be living from YouTube earning, and are there any changes coming in the next year? I'm not really sure about any changes coming in the next year. I kind of always have changes going on the channel at all times, but there definitely will be some new series and stuff coming out very soon. I'm going to try and get my YouTube series going and a bunch of other series started. I'm going to be doing first look camos and first look reticles for Infinite Warfare at some point. I just need to grind, like I said, I need to grind up clips and stuff like that right now. I just need to get ahead of myself a little bit before I start posting all this stuff, because I'm super behind. I'm like, I plan out a video, I'm like, okay, I'm gonna make this video, and then I go on and I'm like, oh shit, I don't have any gameplay. And then I have to sit there for like 2 hours and try and get a good gameplay to use. And that's just why I'm so far behind right now. So any kind of new future plans for the channel right now, I'm working on it. But at the same time, I need to really just get ahead of myself with the gameplay right now. I'm way behind and I need to get on top of that. And as for do I plan to live from YouTube earning, I don't plan for it. I mean, it would be fucking awesome if I could. And I could definitely use the money right now. But I'll get back to you on that one. I mean, it would be awesome. I would really love that. But right now, I'm just not making enough to be able to make that a reality. Even though that's all the money, all the income I have right now is from YouTube earning. It's the only income I have. And I definitely appreciate that income. And I would love for that income to increase. But as for right now, it's not my only plan. It's kind of way up there, like at the top of the list. But it's not my only plan. So we do have a few questions left, even though we are going to go over our allotted time for this video. Of course, it always happens. So I'm going to add in a domination game here on Modern Warfare Remastered. Hopefully we can finish before the first round, but no promises. So first question we have here is CoD Matter on Twitter, and he's asking, what do you do when you're not playing games and editing, etc., like sports or anything? Well, I definitely do not play sports, at least with any style of professionalism, maybe some casual sports from time to time, but I'm more into that kind of geeky, nerdy side of things. I like keeping up with television shows and movies, and that's where that pop culture sort of side of things comes in with my channel. How I said I want to get into more of a pop culture vibe with the future of the channel. I'm really into like things like Game of Thrones and Walking Dead. My favorite show right now on HBO is Westworld. I think that's super interesting, that show with like the robots and the Western and all that kind of crazy like mixture of components and stuff. I'm really into comic booky sort of things. I like watching the Marvel Cinematic Universe, the DC Extended Universe. I'm very interested in The Flash and the Arrow TV shows and all that stuff. You might have actually heard me and Renman discussing them at length in previous live streams. We're always comparing where we are in the series and what we think is going to happen next and sort of stuff like that. I like speculating on the future of all these characters and stuff, fantasy, sci-fi. That's sort of my style, that's sort of my thing. On top of that, I'm really interested in music. Music is a big part of my life. I used to act and sing. I used to play saxophone in high school. I could have gone to university and become a professional musician playing saxophone, but there was this weird thing that happened with my music program about halfway through high school, and it totally got shut down. And you can't really go to university and try and become a professional musician. You can't really even enroll in a university when you never played your grade 12 master solo. So I did my grade 11 master solos, but I never got to grade 12 master solos, and I never got to actually continue my work in that field. So I was really good at playing saxophone. I play guitar casually. I'm kind of okay with it, but just listening to music, listening to metal and all that kind of stuff is my jam. But that is sort of what I do outside of gaming and editing and all that stuff. Is I'm big into movies, big into TV shows, big into music. I read occasionally, but that's mostly it. I watch a lot of YouTube. I watch a ton of YouTube, not just gaming YouTube, like I said, but like news channels and keeping up with the world, and just watching like comedy YouTube and all these skits and all this other kind of stuff. I think you can actually go to the bottom of my channel and find what I'm subscribed to, or my about page or something like that, and you'll get a good feel for all the craziness that I'm interested in. I'm not sure if you can actually see what I'm subscribed to or not with my current setup, but you just be aware that I'm watching all kinds of crazy YouTube. Like, no two channels that I'm subscribed to are that much alike. That's the extent of my YouTube variety that I watch. So we've got Brody asking, what was your first game played, and also what is your all-time favorite game? So the first game I played, I couldn't even tell you. First game ever that I played would have been something on like Sega Genesis or something like that, like really, really old. Then we got the PlayStation 2, which was like the first big console that I played on a lot. So PlayStation 2, I used to play, I can't even think of any of the games I used to play, like Tie the Tasmanian Tiger, Ratchet and Clank, things like that. Like I said earlier, like platformers and stuff, I used to be more interested in, until I got into the first-person shooter franchise. So Ratchet and Clank, God of War, I played a lot of, even though I was very, very young, like way too young to be playing God of War. I was playing God of War, and Grand Theft Auto, stuff like that. So those are kind of the first games I was playing on PS2, and then we kind of moved into PS3, PS4, and onwards and upwards. But first game I ever played would have been something on the Sega Genesis, like Sonic the Hedgehog or something even older than that. So I've been playing games for quite some time. And what is my all-time favorite game? Well, actually, I'd have to go to my notes and tell you. I actually made a list because I keep forgetting of like what my favorite games are. But I actually made a list of some of my favorite games of all time, just because I can't really decide on one over the other. Like, I can't really pick the best game of all time. There is a lot of really good games. I would say most of the best games came with PlayStation 3. Most of my favorite games. So Skyrim, I believe I'm getting that sometime soon, the remaster of Skyrim or the special edition, whatever, for PS4, and we will be streaming that on the channel because it's just one of the best games of all time. Uncharted 2 was one of my favorite games. I did get the remaster of that, the Uncharted Collection. I've been playing that on PS4. I actually beat it like 2 or 3 times on PS4 already. Hopefully we're going to stream that at some point as well. Far Cry 3 for PS3. Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 is one of my absolute all-time favorite games. Crysis 2, I hope they bring out a new Crysis game very soon. It's been a while since they have one of those, and it would be really awesome to get a next-gen Crysis game, because those games were really, really good. If you don't know what Crysis is, definitely look it up. It's super cool. It's kind of indie compared to some of the other big shooter games, like big shooter franchises. The Crysis franchise has kind of played it under like low profile, under the radar, and it's sort of sad because it's a really great series, one of my favorite series of all time. Borderlands was a really great game, the original Borderlands. It sucks that the Handsome Collection that came out for PS4 doesn't include the original Borderlands, because it is the best one. Baldur's Gate Dark Alliance for PS2 was one of my all-time favorite games for PS2. Like I said, Tie the Tasmanian Tiger 2. And I also have Scooby-Doo Night of 100 Frights on here, just because that's such a nostalgic game for me. Just I always occasionally remember things of that game. I'm just like walking around just doing daily activities, and I just, something pops into my brain. I'm thinking about playing that game, and I'm like, man, that was a freaking good game considering its time span, like who made it and when it came out, just being a PlayStation 2 game, not being a super crazy popular game. It's interesting to me that a game like that could stick in my mind for so long. Like, it must have been a good game to deserve its spot in my brain hole, you know? And finally, Ninja Ray asked me the history of the name BlackTideTV or BlackTide15 with being my PSN name. Well, it actually came from two different things. Firstly, my favorite band at the time was BlackTide. Yep, there's a metal band out there called BlackTide. And when I first got my PlayStation 3, I was asked to make a name, and I couldn't think of a really great, unique name. So I'm like, okay, well, I'm gonna call myself BlackTide, and then it was taken, of course. So I'm like, okay, well, I'm gonna add my age. I was 15 when I had my PlayStation 3. I was 14 when I had my PlayStation 3. And I was about to turn 15, so I literally called my PSN BlackTide15, and I just never made another one. I don't see the point in making multiple profiles or making other profiles to continue on or anything like that. I don't really see the point in that, because it's like, I've already got all these trophies. I already look so good on this profile. Like, why would I want to make a second profile and start from scratch? It just doesn't make sense to me. So I'm kicking ass on this profile. I'm gonna continue using this profile. When I first started my YouTube channel, I was like, okay, BlackTide15 is kind of like a really shitty name. I need to come up with a better name. So I'm like, you know, I'm going to try and think of something that's going to kind of relate to actually being a show. It's sort of like a show that you come on and watch. I'm like, we'll call it BlackTideTV. So that's kind of what stuck, and I haven't changed it since. I never will change it, I don't think, as far as I'm planning. If they do finally let you change your name on PS4, if they let you change your PSN name, I will change my PSN name to BlackTideTV to match my YouTube channel name. But for now, my PSN name is still stuck with BlackTide15, which I hate. I hate it because everyone else, they have their YouTube channels, and they have their, well, everyone else that's on, that's playing Call of Duty, and they have their Call of Duty YouTube channels, which, for the most part, aren't that amazing. A lot of people just have their YouTube channel, and they just post, like, random gameplays or whatever, but these other people, they have their YouTube channels, and they're the exact same, the exact identical same as their PSN name, and all they have to do is, in their clan tag or whatever, they just put, like, the YTME, and then you can just look up their exact name. Whereas I can't do that because my name isn't the same. Like, my PSN name, my YouTube name are not the same. And so I basically screwed myself over there with, I can't really just say YouTube me and just look up my gamer tag. It doesn't work that way. So now I have to make my custom emblems. I have to say, like, okay, like, here's my YouTube, like, on my custom emblem, go check it out and all this stuff. It makes it a little bit more difficult. It would be really great if we could get that function to change our name, change our PSN name on PlayStation 4 or on PSN in general. That would be amazing. They actually had a little poll that went out, like Sony had a poll that went out, and they asked what kind of changes people would like to see in future updates of PlayStation 4. And on there they had change your PSN ID, and I was like, oh my god, if that comes out, I'm gonna be so excited. But has not yet come out. When it does, you can definitely expect my name to change from BlackTide15 to BlackTideTV, but the YouTube name will never, never, ever change. It's there for good. That's the history of the name. Those are all the questions I received. Like I said, if you have any questions that didn't get answered, if you'd like to ask me any other questions, definitely just tweet with the hashtag AskBTide. I'll be keeping track of that hashtag for the future, and I will be doing more Q&As in the future. Probably not for 3,000 subscribers, because we're going to hit that pretty soon, but maybe like 5,000, I might do another one, or some kind of like bigger milestone like that, or maybe I'll do something completely different as well. I did plan to do the Jerky XP challenge at one point, or something like that, or do something different. So we'll see what the future holds, but that is it for my Q&A today, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button as well. Yeah, we're almost at 3K already. I mean, like 2130, we're probably, that was when I started this video, and I've been working on recording this video for a good half an hour at least, probably like 45 minutes to an hour recording this video. We're probably at like, I don't even know anymore, like 2150 at this point. It's growing at such a rapid rate, I can't even keep track of it. Absolutely ridiculous. Do not stop telling everybody about BlackTideTV. I don't know what's going on. I don't know why I'm getting all these subscribers, considering the subscriber, quote-unquote subscriber crisis that's happening right now. All these bigger YouTubers are all saying that they're losing subscribers left, right, and center, and here I am gaining them all like crazy. So definitely don't stop whatever you're doing. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. Keep sharing videos whenever you can. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys on the next one.